Jaymi hears the whisper of a sudden silverfish upon the tiles of her bathroom in the Metropolitan Hotel on Asbury Avenue, where he'll be housing her and the imagination thief. And she scoops the silverfish up into a roll of paper and runs down to the Asbury Park boardwalk and lets it go with a kiss to the paper as this little creature of an ancient order slides away, coiling into the moonlight. Sand-hornets cut the air. Glistening on the shore ahead, crustaceans of mud scuttle down over lugworms into lapping wavelets. Further back and down, where the continental shelf ends, a rush and flap of species more exotic. Black goldfish, peroxide-blond fish, then express fish and sea-serpents. Then, listening back to when the mountains were seabeds, the mountainfish, now in fossil form upon the rock. She reclines by the petrified mountainfish. Jaymi goes to join her and they sit, like bees on a rock face, waiting for the sun, ricochet of rabbits in the mountains, scampering. Pebbles scatter, feathers ripping up through a yellow-grey sky, then a shortwave piping of peewits and curlews. White horses flow through her soundtrack now, where the art of the mouse is hidden too. For the mountain is bestial. Sylphs and gnomes and manticores bound up its slopes, under Evelyn's direction. At her whim, a stately sheep, a blonde sheep, peevish to be sure, but ceremonial, processional, passes by in front of her and Jaymi, then recedes to the left. Out above the mountain range ahead, a vision dances, with shafts of light, cloudscapes, horses' heads and circles in the sky. Then Jaymi feels Evelyn clap her hands with easy grace and lands back down in the Melrose Avenue building, with her soundtrack completed and the feeling of a violin flower open wide in him.